Good morning, Yogi Bears. Welcome back to The Space Between. This morning we're going to do a nurturing vinyasa flow with a focus on our root chakra, or muladhara chakra. So feel free to wear something comfy. I'm literally in my Harry Potter PJs. Ta-da! Because I am doing this on a Saturday morning, and I'm going to be going to teach a yoga class in about an hour or two, about an hour and a half. Anyway, so if you have any, ginger flower and patchouli. I've got this ginger flower and patchouli candle for $4.99. So if you have any ginger scents or patchouli, that's really good for helping us to feel a little bit more grounded. So you could either maybe spray the scent if you have it, or light a candle like I'm doing, just because, why not? It will help to stimulate muladhara a little bit. Yeah, so wear something comfy. We're going to begin with a short kind of meditation, and then we're going to move on to our nurturing flow. If you like this video, please do feel free to give it a thumbs up or hit the subscribe button, and thank you very much for joining me today. Okay then, guys, so we're going to begin in a comfortable seated position. You're going to roll the shoulders back and down, straighten the spine. Maybe take a few deep breaths. And I think we'll begin today with a little body scan. So we're going to close the eyes. We're going to start from the crown of the head. I'm going to slowly scan from the crown of the head down over the eyes, along the back of the head, scanning over the nose, the cheeks, the lips, scanning over the jaw and the chin, scanning down the neck, noticing any areas of tension in the neck. Absolutely normal. Try not to change it, just be aware. Scanning down the chest, and then we're going to get to our left shoulder. I'm going to slowly scan from the top of the left shoulder to the left elbow. Continue scanning down the left arm towards the wrist. Scanning down towards the fingertips. Noticing any difference in your left and right arms. Before we bring the attention to the right shoulder, I'm going to slowly scan down the right shoulder. Towards the elbow, scanning down to the right wrist, scanning down the fingers and the thumb. Bringing the attention to the chest, slowly scanning down. Scanning the ribs, remembering that they wrap around the body. Being aware of the spine too, as you're slowly scanning down towards the diaphragm, towards the belly. Resting on the hips. And then maybe just bring your left hand to your chest, your right hand to your belly. And just taking some deep breaths. Actually, let's not take some deep breaths. Let's just take our normal breaths and see where those breaths are. So you find that you're doing nice deep belly breaths, or are you finding that your breath is quite short and sharp? I'm not trying to change that, but just being aware that by being aware of the breath, you automatically tend to slow it down a little bit, and you tend to breathe a little bit deeper. And you'll probably find throughout today's practice that by the end of practice, by the end of this tutorial, you'll be breathing a bit deeper, a bit slower, and just more fully Nice full, I'm not sure fully is a word. Nice full deep breaths. Nice and fully. Release the hands to the knees, bringing the focus to the left hip. Slowly scanning down the left hip. Down the left buttocks and thigh. Down the left knee. Down towards the ankle. Down the left ball of the foot, long to the toe pads, all along the sole of that left foot. Noticing any differences between your left and right leg before you bring the attention to your right leg, to the right hip, scanning down the right buttocks, the right thigh. Scanning down towards the knee and then down towards the heel of the foot. Scanning all the way along the right foot to the ball and every toe pad. Good. Just checking in with the mind, checking in with the body, seeing where you're at today. I'm feeling pretty excited because I've got some YouTube videos for October that I'm very excited about to share with you guys. So that's how I'm feeling this morning. You can keep the eyes closed or you can open them. And I'm just going to talk you through a technique called Samavritti. And I actually have a separate video tutorial for this, so I will link it in the description box below for you guys. It's a really simple breath exercise. I will explain it quickly here, and then if you need to have a look at it properly, you can. But it is very simple. So what we're going to do is we're going to inhale. We're going to do an inhale retention. We're going to do an exhale and an exhale retention. So it's four parts. That's why it's also known as square breath. And we're going to count to four as well. So you can do four, five, six. You could start at four and work your way up. This is a technique that I, the pranayama, that I actually completely forgot about until the other day. And so I'm starting at four as well. And then I'm hoping in my own practice a little bit that I am going to work up maybe to five, six, and so on. Okay, so it's really nice and simple. I think definitely if you have the time, it's nice to do this for at least 5 minutes, maybe even 10. We probably won't do it for too long today just because I want to get into the main flow. So if you wanted to hit pause, if you have the luxury of time, then do feel free to hit pause here and do it a little bit longer if you like. It's up to you. Okay. Alright then, so we're going to inhale for a count of four. Two, one. Inhale retention, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale retention, 2, 3, 4. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Retention, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, retention, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so it's quite simple, as you can see. When I say retention, guys, we're just holding on to that exhale, okay? Letting it all out and then staying there for 4 seconds. All right, so I'm not going to count this time. I'm just going to do a couple, and you can try and do it with me as well. It's very nice and grounding, this technique, and it's really calming, so that's why I'm using it for Muladhara chakra or root chakra. Okay, inhale. the hand, slowly fluttering open the eyes. Okay, lovely. Hopefully feeling a little bit more grounded, a little bit more calm. I'm going to switch my legs over. You might want to shake them out as well. I'm a little bit stiff this morning, as is often the way in the mornings. Okay. Let me stretch it out a little bit. Oh, that feels good. Okay. Alright, I'm going to place my right hand on the ground, slash on my mat. You can close the eyes here as well if you like, guys. We're going to bring, reach over and lean. Keeping that shoulder open. Maybe bringing the gaze up to the ceiling. Exhale, bring this one over. Inhale. One more time each side. Good. Tuck my Harry Potter chummies in so I'm not flashing my little Buddha belly to the world. Gonna interlace the fingers behind the back. We're gonna interlace the odd one on top. So undo it and then interlace again. Roll the shoulders back. Maybe lifting away from the bum. Maybe working out any kinks in the neck. That feels good. Very yawny today, sorry guys. Did just wake up, so bear with. Good, let's bring those arms up and over. I'm going to inhale, reach up, and exhale, planting the fingers. Okay, we're going to find a little bit of space, a little bit of wiggle room here. Inhale, draw the chest forward. Exhale, start to lean over. Inhale. Inhale and exhale. Slowly start to walk the hands back. Ta-da-da. Working out any kinks in the neck. Okay. Let's bring our hands to our knees. We're going to inhale and drop to the right. And then when you get to the center, you're going to start to exhale. As you go back, try and keep those sit bones nice and grounded even when you're leaning forwards. Working those hips. Moving with the breath. And the other way, inhale. Exhale. Neutral spine, spread those hands and inhale, looking up, arching the back. Exhale, curling the back. This is just some seated cat cows, okay? Oh, yawn it out. One more time. Right, we're going to come onto our hands and our knees. I'm going to tuck myself in so I don't flash anyone. Nobody needs to see a builder's bum at this time of the morning. Alright. Spreading those hands, we're going to do a few more cat cows. So we're going to inhale, lean up. And exhale. Yeah. bring it to a wide leg stance. We're going to touch the toes and we're going to just gently come back down into child's pose. And we use this pose quite a lot in the Ajna Chakra series I've just done. And it's great for Ajna Chakra because we've got our attention on our forehead at the level of the third eye, but it's also a really nice rooting posture. So I do recommend switching up the focus, seeing how that makes you feel, seeing what comes up. So we're gonna inhale, straighten the spine, straighten the arms. And then as we exhale, we're just finding a little bit more space in the hips. We're really focusing on that rooting sensation. Maybe you want to set an intention today for the class. Now is a great time to do that, whether it's to ground down a little bit more, to find your roots, to feel steadier, stronger. You can do that. You can also just take this time out for a little bit of TLC, top up your cup, because we all know you can't pour from an empty cup, right? We're going to come up into our tabletop. I'm going to curl the toes under and bring my feet together a little bit more. And I'm going to come into my first downward facing dog. Now, I'm on a bit of a slippery surface here, guys, so bear with. And we're going to really spread the fingers. I'm going to bend the knees, pull gently the belly button towards the back of the spine, maybe wiggle out the head a little bit. Opening the shoulders like they're jam jar lids. We're going to walk the dog, so pedal out the feet. Should be about hip width apart. Doesn't matter if your feet can't touch the ground, if your heels can't touch the ground in this posture, okay? Good, and then come to static dog. We're going to bring, I might have to wiggle forwards a bit actually, we're going to swing the right leg back and we're going to bend the knee, rotate the hip, bring the gaze underneath the right arm. Maybe do some ankle circles if that feels good. We're going to swing it forward, we're going to step it down, we're going to bring our left knee down. We're going to move so that the toes are facing the outer corner edge of the mat and bring the hands in. You can stay here or, if available to you, you can go down onto your elbows. I'm going to stay up because it's first thing in the morning and I'm still warming up. I'm going to open up that front foot onto the outer edge. My hand's right in the way, isn't it? Sorry, so it should look like that, guys. I'm going to bring my right arm up. Okay. Bring the hand down, move the foot so it's in the centre, ready to step into our first forward bend. I'm working out any kinks. We're going to inhale, halfway up, lift. And exhale a little bit deeper if we can. Again, you might bend the knees a little bit like I'm doing, just as we warm up today. Bringing the hands to the ground, making sure that they're nice and grounded and strong. Ready to step back. Step back into downward facing dog. Okay. And then we're going to do our first vinyasa. So we're actually just going to do some easy ones today because this is a nurturing flow. So if you want to, you can do a full hover down with your chaturanga. You can do one leg in the air. But I'm just going to do the simplest option today because that's how I'm feeling. So we're going to hover over into high plank, bend the knees, and then you can do two options actually for the easy. So the first is to kind of go down almost like a wave and then you come back up. So let's do that and then come back into our downward facing dog. The second option is to come over into high plank.
and then knees, chest and chin. Okay, you can come up into Sphinx with the elbows down, grounding down those toes, nice activated legs, or you can come up into Bhujangasana or Cobra, keeping the elbows towards the body, hips are still on the ground, and the toes are grounded, okay? So those are your two options. You can go kind of roll down like a wave, or you can do knees, chest, chin. I'll probably do knees, chest, chin, just because it's a bit easier for me, so I don't headbutt my bookcase. Okay. Swinging the left leg back, bend at the knee, roll open at the hips. Again, doing some circles. I'm gonna step it forward. Bend the right knee, bring those toes out so they're facing outwards, bring the hands in. And again, you can come onto the elbows or you can stay here, whatever feels good. Focusing on grounding, grounding through the soles, the feet. Opening out that front foot and the left arm comes up. Feel a bit of an openness in the shoulders and the hips. Okay, bring it back down with the other foot forward, stepping into our forward bend. Inhale, halfway uplift. And exhale. Okay, let's step back into our downward facing dog. We're going to hover over into high plank and take your variation on doing knees, chest, chin. Again, you can do cobra if this feels good. Coming up into downward dog. And come onto the tiptoes. We're going to step to the front with the right leg. Come into a bit of a lunge here. And then open up here. The chin is still facing forwards. Try and wiggle back a bit, guys, because I'm probably gonna cut my head off. Okay. Gonna inhale, rotate, lean forward, exhale, up and over. Reverse warrior. Bring your hands down. Stepping it back into a high plank and taking a vinyasa here. Curl the toes under. I'm going to lift up with the left leg and I'm going to repeat on the other side. Nice and strong. And then opening up for warrior two. Inhale, leaning forwards, exhale, up and over, reverse warrior. Trying to keep that shoulder nice and open. Windmill the hands down, stepping back into high plank. Vinyasana. Curl those toes under. Good. And lift the right leg, step it forwards. Open up into warrior two. I'm going to interlace the hands behind the back. Bend a little bit forwards. I'm going to bend like so. So just bending from the hips. Allowing the hands to come as far as they may. Again, focusing on that grounding. Spreading the toes. Trying to keep that spine straight. Letting those hands down. Stepping back into a high plank. Taking your vinyasa, coming up to downward facing dog. Bringing the left leg back, stepping it forwards nice and strong. High lunge. Opening up to warrior two. Again, interlacing the hands, this time the odd hand can go on top. Keeping that front knee bent. I'm so sorry guys, I am on carpet, which is just so slippery, so hopefully you have a little bit more sturdiness. It's giving me a bit of an extra Muladhara chakra challenge, let's just say. Good, interlace the hands. Nice and strong. Nice and grounding. We're gonna frame the front foot. And we're gonna take Parvanyasana down. Closing the eyes. Bringing the knees down. Coming into our child's pose. Taking a few breaths, maybe coming back to your intention. Coming back up through tabletop into downward facing dog. Stepping the right leg forwards, coming into high lunge. Opening up for our warrior two. This time we're going to open up both the feet. Maybe closing the eyes, focusing on grounding here. Bringing the hands to the hips, and then lean forwards. Nice straight legs. If you want to, you can interlace the fingers. Oh my gosh, it's so slippery, sorry guys. You can interlace the big toe with the big finger, with the forefinger even, if I engage my brain. And really pushing the sternum in front. Maybe closing the eyes, taking some deep breaths. Focusing on that grounding, really spreading the toes and the feet. Bring the hands to the center. Point them back. Walking the hands back a little bit towards the back of your mat. You'll probably go a bit further than I can. And bring them forward once more. And we're going to bring the left heel in a little bit because we're going to come down to our left side. Okay. So this is our Skandasana. And if you can come onto your whole foot, that's great. I can sometimes when I'm really warmed up, but obviously it's first thing in the morning, so I can't right now. Bringing the hands in front, you can bring them up like so. You could even do a little bind if you want to. Okay, wherever you feel good. Pick a focus point. Hands down, we're gonna come back over onto the other side here. And again, really focusing on grounding down through the feet. Hands at heart center in a motion of gratitude. Hands come down, let's go over once more. Muladhara chakra, colour is red. Grounding into some gratitude here. And one more time. Okay, bring the hands to the front, ready to swivel back. Ready for a vinyasa. Lift the left leg, bring that forward. And we can interlace the fingers, or you could even take a bind. Like so here, if you wanted to.
just to see how that feels.
I'm actually going to face this way, guys, so you can see me a little bit more. Let's bring it out to the side. And let's interlace the fingers behind the back.
Bring the tip forward. Again, nice wide-legged stance. Muladhara chakra, element of earth, grounding down through those toes, and then maybe bending the knees as you come up.
Okay, I'm on the opposite side to you guys, but you're gonna come towards your right foot, so you wanna have your right knee bent, and then you're gonna do a little bit of a bind if you can. Bring my feet together a little bit more. My mat is just slipping all over the place. I hope that yours is not. Okay, we're going to do a little bit of our grounding goddess now. Just going to move this. Sorry, guys. There we go. Okay, so. Get that. Early morning. Early morning feels, guys. Okay, I'm going to spread with the feet. I like to go quite wide with my feet, not super wide. My heels are a bit turned in. And I come into a bit of a bend, like so. Yeah. Okay, almost like I'm going to do sort of a plie or something. Rolling the shoulders back. Tucking the tailbone under a little bit. Maybe bringing the arms up. Our goddess pose. Nice and strong and sturdy in the feet. Bringing the hands down. I'm going to bring my left shoulder forwards and I'm going to take my chin over my right shoulder for a little bit of a twisted goddess. Again, trying to bring the tailbone down a little bit. And then switch to the other side. Every time I'm inhaling, I'm straightening my spine. And every time I exhale, I'm trying to find a bit more space. Ground it down through the feet. Good, bring it to the center. Wiggle those feet in a little bit, ready to come to a loopy squat. Again, play around with the width of the feet here. Maybe rock it from side to side. Closing the eyes. Maybe whilst the hands are at heart center, just thinking of something you feel gratitude for. Even if it's small things. Being grounded through the feet. Just gently, let's just reach forward and then slowly coming onto the mat here. And then, just about to see, we're going to come into a forward fold, and you can use a strap here, guys, if you need to. Keeping the feet out in front of us, going to flex those feet, stretch up. And then coming over, reaching forward with the chest, a little bit deeper. Again, really grounding down with the sit bones, and reaching into our Muladhara. And then lastly, I think what we'll do is we'll just come onto the knees, but we're going to come onto the, so we're going to curl the toes under. So you're coming onto your heels with your toes curled under. And really just spreading the toes here. Just really stretching the feet, the soles of the feet. Really bringing up the arm as well, so you can perhaps just move the wrist a little bit. So that feels good. Maybe bring in the show on my sleeves. Bring in the wrists right into the hips so that the shoulders are popped. And then if we can roll the head a little bit further back with some support from the shoulders or from the trapeze, I think it's called. Good, release that. Feel the feet. Probably starting to hurt a bit now. Really stretching out those feet. Nice and grounding. And then we're going to put the hands on the knees and allow them to curl under. Okay, just sitting here for a moment, maybe bringing the hands to heart. Closing the eyes. Try and think of something, one more thing you feel grateful for. Muladhara Chakra, Mother Nature, element of Earth. Finding our grounding, finding our foundations, making them strong. Balancing this chakra so that we feel safe and calm. Okay. And then for at least 5 minutes, take a Shavasana here. So, allowing the feet to come to the outer corner edges of the mat and relax. Coming down, maybe lifting a little bit. If you like, I have a nice video on like a grounding visualization. You could put that on. I'll leave a link below as well. It might be quite nice to finish off with if you want something a bit different for your Shavasana. Otherwise, just try and think about the tailbone grounding, the heels grounding, the shoulders. Everything relaxing a little bit more. Closing the eyes. Noticing the breath. Nice big belly breaths. And I just want to say thank you very much for joining me today. And thank yourselves as well for showing up to your mat. I hope that when you finish, when you peel yourself off, you feel a little bit more grounded and safe. Namaste.